Well, we are back with a different channel. Do you know that? I will be reacting to Daniel Dolan's video to skin buildings that actually exist. Is that as
Look at the woman!
Carnival. There's even a colossal statue inspired by circus giant Alex Marley, who stood proudly at 7 feet 11 inches. The Greek statue pays homage to Alex's incredible size 27 feet. If you care about the cast, color, or noble characters, stop by Showtime breakfast trailers and elephants on the lawn. Just maybe don't leave your lions unattended.
Number 14.
But the real deal after this. The native with small, precious riverside towns simply begs to sell in their sultry
streets.
Wow, how do you pronounce that? The remarkable thing about Dipping Hill Bay is its structure has incredibly curved into the surrounding cliffsides and partway above it. Residents in the lower half of the town live in cave-like structures, built into a grove that has large rock formations jutting out over the streets. The town is also famous for its cultivation of Mediterranean food and its cafes, which serve as a leftover assortment of local chorizo, almonds, and olives. Definitely one to check out if you're in the area. Manaus is the smallest jurisdiction in the U.S. It was founded by Czech migrants in northeast Nebraska and is home only to a single resident, 77-year-old Elsie Eller. In the 1930s, the town had a population of about 150, but by the turn of the millennium, only two people lived there, Elsie and her husband, Rudy. Unfortunately, Rudy passed away in 2004, leaving Elsie as the town's sole resident. But don't worry, she keeps busy. Elsie is Manaus' clerk, treasurer, and head of council, and she runs the town's only tavern and library. Oh, and she's also the mayor of Cleveland. No, that's it. I'm sure she's a sweet old lady, but you have to admit, this is a pretty bizarre situation. I'm surprised no one's come in there to attack the town and build a Walmart. Elsie pays the annual tax to maintain the town's four streetlights and provide other basic amenities. Without any city upkeep, several of the abandoned buildings in town have become collapsed. Others have collapsed completely.
Number 12.
Hong Kong's Kowloon Walled City has the highest human population density of anywhere on the planet, with an area of only 6.5 acres. An estimated 50,000 people were said to live within its walls. Originally a Chinese military fort, the British forces commandeered it in 1898. When China announced intentions to reclaim it, refugees poured in by the thousands. The British couldn't evict them, so they pulled out. But when the Chinese proved uninterested in maintaining Kowloon, the city became a cesspool of drugs and crime. In the 60s, it was run by an organized crime syndicate, the Triads. There was a construction zone in the 70s, and residents built dwellings as they wished, disregarding safety codes. There was squalor and overpopulation, but people remained there. Eventually, Chinese officials found the living conditions intolerable and made plans to demolish the buildings. They compensated residents and forced evacuated them in 1991. In 1995, the site became as mad for all things extraterrestrial as everyone and their dog knows. The residents believe a UFO crash-landed in the town during the 1940s, and, ever since then, they've molded the town to fit the phenomenon. UFO tourism attracts many travelers. Visitors love frequenting these UFO-themed alien zone shops, crashing at local motels, and wearing their tinfoil hats to the annual Summer UFO Festival. Even the local McDonald's is shaped like a flying saucer. Skeptics and believers alike will have plenty to argue about after a visit to the International UFO Museum and Research Center. If you're looking for a quaint, alien-inspired slice of small-town America, visit Roswell. Get out of this world.
Number
10. The ancient slum town of Nightshade Castle looks like the aftermath of a natural disaster. Every square inch is covered with rotting garbage collected from the nearby city of Cairo. But hey, the town's 60,000 inhabitants don't seem to mind. That's because the town's entire economy revolves around the collection and recycling of Cairo's garbage. Cairo has established an efficient garbage collection service to the outsourced departments of the labor. Nancy at NASA's garbage people, who is Abilene, collect trash from Cairo in a door-to-door service and transport it via donkey-drawn carts. This practice has gone on for 70 years. Unfortunately, in 2003, Cairo's government hired private garbage removal companies, which the Zabarin had struggled to compete against. The government also ordered the culling of Manchet Nassau's 350,000 pigs, which were a critical part of the Zabarin's recycling operation. In short, the Cairo government is full of jerks.
Number 9.
Cairo is known as the city of the slums because of its many cemeteries. It has a Jewish, Chinese, and a pet cemetery, among others. The city was founded as an actual necropolis in 1924, and, with an estimated population of 2 million dead, it's fair to say Cairo has way more dead folk in it than its partially 1,200 living residents. It's great to be alive in Cairo, but let the city certify this is the last place you want to be come the inevitable zombie apocalypse.
Number 8.
Cairo's The Villages is the largest gated retirement community in the world. It's home to more than 100,000 people aged over 55 and has a ban on children. Although it sounds like the ideal retirement community, The Villages also has a secret, scandalous side. The community has seen a boom in public sex and STDs. Not the kind of thing you're likely to imagine when you picture your dear old grandparents in their retirement home. There's also a black market for Viagra, which, if you're wondering, costs about $12 a pill. There are approximately 10 women to every man, and the community has been dubbed Disney World for old people. There are more golf carts in this community than cars, so if you plan on driving through, prepare to go really, really slow. Elisa, this Russian city is the capital of the Republic of Comakia. The designers and architects were so obsessed with chess, the game of kings, that they based the entire town around this theme.
It
has a chess city, the dome complex that once hosted the 1998 Chess Olympiad. Or, if you're more about taking the chess game to the streets, at least it has a giant chessboard painted on the town square floor. Unsurprisingly, many of the world's finest chess players have visited Elisa. It's the only British region in Europe and has a world-renowned museum of British art. What Buddhism has to do with chess, I'm not really sure, but it's still a unique town to visit. Checkmate.
Number 6.
Battleship Island. This Japanese island's claim to fame is that it's completely walled in by a fake battleship. For decades, it was uninhabited, but the word that spread from curious travelers who saw it on the horizon has turned it into a tourism phenomenon. This new island has become dilapidated from years of disuse, but tourists still flock there for a spooky tour. Kingstown. Most Western cities have a Chinatown area to call their own, but did you know that China itself has a small town that is a perfect imitation of a British city? Kingstown is a remarkable British-themed town in the suburb of Shanghai. It features traditional English architecture and cuisine, cobblestone streets, and the iconic buildings that many identify with London. Visitors can enjoy a punt at the local British pub, a snack at the local fish and chip shop, and can pose by statues of famous UK experts Harry Potter and James Bond. Many local couples flock here for their wedding photos, because nothing says they love you like posing with celebrity statues. Yakajima. This island town is full of residents who were paid by the Japanese government to live there. This is because the city is situated at the base of an active volcano, so the inhabitants are exposed to unnaturally high levels of sulfur. Living there comes with a risk of being poisoned, so it's only fair they be compensated. Townspeople often wear gas masks to endure the toxic air. The town is otherwise quite pleasant, and it's been speculated that the Japanese government is conducting a sort of unofficial experiment with the Yakajima residents. Maybe, what are the effects of long-term sulfur exposure? I'm betting that they aren't good. China's Dwarf Village is pretty much exactly what it sounds like. It's a small township community that's been specifically designed for little people. In this incredible tiny wonderland, the smaller-sized residents can feel equal and comfortable without attracting those lingering southern looks that they sometimes have to contend with in the rest of the world. Unfortunately, one of this town's novelty is disrespectful tourists now flock to the area to
drop.
It's a real shame.
Number 2.
Kirikiri is a unique Australian town that is almost completely underground. Its underground structure remains from old abandoned mines, and the town is world famous for the beautiful opals mined there. I guess it's better than being famous for being a city covered in garbage. Cougar PD is known as a very cool and relaxed place to live, since most of the residents get to go about their days shielded from the harsh South Australian sun. To be honest, this is probably what all towns will look like after the apocalypse. I guess they're just one step ahead of everybody else.
Number one.
Whittier. Almost all of Whittier's 200-plus inhabitants live inside a single 14-story building called Vegas Towers. The rest live in their cars, trucks, boats, or in the one other similar building. This makes for a pretty unique town. Built in 1956, Vegas Towers originally served as an Alaskan army barracks. But nowadays, it's a thriving town with a police station, post office, store, church, shop, playground, and health center, all of which are located inside the building. So on a strip club, we've got the making of one cool town. Access to the town is done by crossing the sea or by driving through a 4-kilometer single-lane tunnel, which only opens twice every hour. The tunnel also closes at night, so if the idea of being trapped inside this icy building town scares you, then maybe you should pick this one out.
That's it, this countdown.
Come on!
That's it. Thanks for watching.
We'll see you soon.
Yes.